Did you know that in your first trimester, your baby is going to grow around 300 times larger from a 4-week embryo to a 13-week fetus? To help you visualize this, your baby is going to grow from the size of something smaller than a pinhead to about the size of a lemon. So in this video, I'm going to talk about baby development during the first trimester, and I'm also going to talk about symptoms that you might be experiencing and what to expect at your OB appointment. But first, if you're new here, welcome to Diana in the Pink. My name is Diana. I'm a physician assistant and I specialize in women's health and gynecology. You are watching In the Pink, and if you're new here, In the Pink means in good health and spirit. So if you like being healthy and happy, make sure to click that subscribe button because you are in the right place. Now, before I get into this video, I want to know what brought you here. Are you pregnant now? And if so, how far along are you? Put that in the comment section down below. I'd love to read about where you're coming from. So, starting off with, what can you expect in the first month of your pregnancy? Well, technically, you won't even know you're pregnant yet for the most part of the first month. During the first month, you might not feel anything yet. The symptoms associated with pregnancy only begin once the embryo has implanted under the uterus, because that's the time when the hormones surge. Early in pregnancy, you might start to notice that your breasts are more tender, you might feel nauseated or start vomiting already, and that usually gets worse in the second trimester. As for your baby, there's not gonna be any recognizable human features in your baby just yet. Their brains are the first thing that start to develop, starting from the neural tube. If you have planned your pregnancy and you've been taking folic acid in the prior month, it's gonna help with this part of development to ensure that you have a healthy baby. The heart and the structures that will later become the urinary system, the bladder, and the uterus will also start out as tubes and ducts. The gender can't yet be determined at this stage yet because it will only appear as genital folds. At the end of the first month, the bronchial and the lobes of the lungs will also start to develop. By the way, if you want a more detailed breakdown of pregnancy, like week by week instead of trimester by trimester, I have made a detailed pregnancy series where each week I will walk you through baby development, common pregnancy symptoms and how to help with them, what to expect at your next OB appointment, and pregnancy must-haves. So if you want to check that out, I'm gonna link to that right here and also at the end of this video. But back to month two. Once your pregnancy test comes out positive, the next question that you might ask is, how soon should I visit my OBGYN? There's no real hard and fast rule for this. You can visit your OBGYN as soon as you have a positive pregnancy test, and by then they'd be able to prescribe you prenatal vitamins if you're not already taking them and counsel you on proper nutrition. If you visit too early, however, they may not be able to do an ultrasound just yet. The gestational sac, which is the earliest recognizable feature of a pregnancy, which just looks like a small dark circular shape on the ultrasound, it can't be seen until you are in your fifth week of pregnancy. So ideally, the first visit to your OBGYN might be somewhere between 6 to 10 weeks, but some OBs choose to not see you till around 12 weeks. If you do visit your OBGYN too early and they can't see anything on ultrasound, it's okay. Your OB will probably ask you to just come back for an ultrasound when it's most likely that they'll be able to hear a heartbeat on your baby. And the earliest that you can hear the baby's heartbeat is about 6 to 6.5 weeks. On your first prenatal check, your doctor is gonna ask you a lot of questions about your symptoms. This is probably gonna be the longest visit that you're gonna have with your provider. They are gonna ask you about any vaginal bleeding, abdominal pain, vaginal discharge, and depending on the timing and the amount, your OBGYN can determine if your bleeding is worrisome or if it's just that implantation bleeding. So make sure to tell your OB if you are having any kind of bleeding at all. They will also discuss your proper diet, exercise, and help you understand what proper weight gain is. The adage of eating for two is actually totally inaccurate.
I can't. I mean, you can't. This is pizza margarita in Napoli.
Remember, number two right now is like that big. And so in the first trimester, you don't need to change how many calories you're consuming at all. Your doctor is also gonna examine you in your first pregnancy. They're gonna measure your blood pressure, your weight. They're also going to feel for your fundus, which is the top of your uterus. Early in the first trimester, the uterus is still down low in the pelvis and it won't be felt above the pubic bone. They're also gonna check prenatal labs. They wanna make sure that you are not anemic, so they're gonna check your blood count or a CBC. They wanna check your blood type, a UA or urinalysis to look for infections. They'll also check a pap test. They're gonna check for sexually transmitted infections like syphilis, hepatitis B, rubella, and HIV. They're also gonna discuss with you options for testing for chromosome abnormalities like Down syndrome. Just be aware that the prenatal testing is all routine. It doesn't mean that your doctor is assuming you're carrying any sexual sexually transmitted infections. They do that for all their pregnant patients. By the end of your second month, your baby is no longer medically classified as an embryo. After 8 weeks, they're now called a fetus. In the ultrasound, your baby would measure around 2 centimeters long. The brain now has a left and a right hemisphere. Their eyelids are starting to form, and the structures that make up their ears and their ear canals and also the cochlea are starting to form too. The liver and the pancreas and the stomach also are starting to form at this time. Their hands and their feet are starting to separate into digits, but the fingers and toes are still webbed. Also during the second month of pregnancy, many women do experience morning sickness. So during this time, you're gonna have a surge of hormones, progesterone and estrogen, and also HCG, which will cause nausea and vomiting. However, if it happens too often and you can't control it, where you can't keep anything down, make sure to let your OB know. They can give you prescription medications to help you out. Sometimes they have to admit you for IV hydration because they don't want you to get an electrolyte imbalance or dehydration. But if your morning sickness isn't too bad, they might suggest that you take over-the-counter vitamin B6, doxylamine, or you could also just try ginger, like ginger tea, which is totally safe during pregnancy. If you wanna know more about how to help with morning sickness, I've done a video all about it. It goes through very detailed steps that you can do to help, so I'm gonna link to that video right here. Check that out if you're struggling with that. You're also most likely gonna start to experience food cravings. It's generally nothing to worry about, unless it's something called pica. Pica is a craving for inedible things, and it tends to happen when you are anemic, where people will try to eat things like dirt or clay, and it's even more concerning if somebody's trying to eat something inedible that is toxic for either you or the baby. But if you're craving specific foods like mangoes or ice cream, that's totally fine. That's okay to munch on too. Sometimes people will crave weird combinations, pickles and ice cream or whatever it is.
Well, see how you choose it, you want them.
That's right.
If you've had weird cravings in your pregnancy, I'd like to know about that. Put that in the comment section down below. Another huge thing to start to expect is fatigue and mood changes during this month as well. It's not really known why, except to know that you are having this huge hormone surge, but knowing that it's normal can help you to deal with your symptoms. Don't compare yourself to other expectant mothers who might look like they're glowing and comfortable throughout their whole pregnancy. No two pregnancies are exactly the same. Give yourself a lot of rest. Sleep in that extra hour if you can, take naps during the day, whatever you need to do to help yourself feel better. Let's move on to the third month of your pregnancy. At this point, a baby bump might actually start to be showing for some women. If you haven't told anybody yet, the people around you might start to notice a little something different. Your pants might become a little bit more tight, and it's also time for another OBGYN visit. The frequency of your visits actually depends on your pregnancy risk. High-risk pregnancies, like if you're having problems with high blood pressure, gestational diabetes, previous pregnancy loss, or maybe even advanced maternal age, may make your OB want you to be seen a little bit more often, but in general, in the first and second trimester, they usually want to see you about once a month. On your second prenatal visit, your doctor's gonna review your lab results with you that they checked from the first visit. They're gonna check if you're gaining the right amount of weight and if you're eating the right kinds of foods. If you are treated for any kind of infection on your first visit, they may opt to do what's called a test of cure, just to make sure the treatment worked. At this time, your baby's gonna be around 6 to 7 centimeters and will weigh about 28 grams. The fundus of your baby bump will be right above the pubic bone at this point. Your baby is gonna start to have discernible fingers and toes and nails. Their skin is developing, their hair might start to appear as well. The brain is gonna start to show discernible lobes. You're gonna see lips and a tongue on your baby, and the ears are starting to take shape. You're probably not gonna be able to feel any discernible movement, but your baby is starting to move quite a bit.
I can't stop this feeling.
Usually you won't feel movements until the middle part of your second trimester, usually around 16 to 20 weeks. Also through the third trimester, you might start to be having other symptoms of pregnancy, like constipation and urinary frequency. Elevated hormones tend to decrease your bowel activity, hence increasing the transit time in your large intestines. And also there's higher absorption of water in your bowels because of the increased need for your body. Drinking a lot of water can help decrease constipation. If you're really struggling with constipation, talk to your OB about taking a stool softener. Probably the most notable symptom of your first trimester after morning sickness and fatigue is having to go to the bathroom often. This is normal and it's totally expected because of the increasing size of your uterus pressing on your bladder. And pregnancy itself causes an increase in volume in the fluids in your body, which leads to increased urine production. It can be bothersome to urinate so frequently. And it might be tempting to want to drink less so you don't have to pee as often, but that's definitely not recommended. Make sure to still drink plenty of water. Just know that you might have to get up a couple of times during the night to pee, and that's totally normal. Just note that if you're having increased frequency and it also burns when you pee, that might be a symptom of a urinary infection, so make sure to talk to your OB about that. The first trimester can be very exciting and also very anxiety-inducing, especially if it's your first baby. Just make sure to continue your healthy lifestyle and see your OB on your regular visits, and you're gonna do great. Now, the best is yet to come. The second trimester is when you are going to feel the best, and a lot of exciting things are gonna happen. I am working on a video for the second trimester, so make sure you hit the notification bell so you don't miss when that video comes out. And as promised, I'm gonna link right here to my pregnancy series, walking you through pregnancy week by week. Click on that, find the week that you're at, maybe check out a few weeks earlier so you can get it all caught up. So click on that link right here, and I will see you over there.